that much of production capacity because India, we are not a developed economy. We are still struggling there. So which means India is always under an inflationary pressure. It's okay. As long as that inflation should be under control. Am I making sense to you all? People who have come today, don't write anything, just keep listening. Before I move on to that, when we say increase in prices, what is the impact of increase in prices? What happens when prices increase? How does it affect us? Come on. Let's say, for example, you want to buy this marker. This is 30 rupees. Okay? And this becomes 100 rupees. What happens? You know, your purchasing power, maybe you are buying 3 pens today, you will buy only 1 pen. So your purchasing power decreases. What you were purchasing before, which means if your purchasing power is decreasing, what is happening to demand? Demand is decreasing. If demand is decreasing, what will happen to production? Production will decrease. Demand is decreasing, production will decrease, no? If production decreases, what will happen? People will start losing jobs. And what will happen to the net result in GDP also will fall down. See, what is the ultimate objective? Always remember, ultimate objective is always to increase production. This is our ultimate objective, to increase production. $2.8 trillion, you want to make a $5 trillion means we want to increase production. What is the impact of increase in production? Increase in production will lead to increase in GDP. Increase in GDP will lead to increase in economic growth. What is the other impact? Increase in production will lead to increase in jobs. Increase in jobs will lead to increase in income levels. Increase in income levels will lead to increase in consumption. Increase in consumption will lead to increase in demand. Increase in demand will lead to what? Increase in production. This is a continuous process which is happening there. Am I clear? So, ultimate target for all of us obviously is to what? Increase production. That's what we said. We want an economic growth. We need increase in production. But then, what is the situation in India? What kind of a country are we? We are not an excess producing country. We are a country which has less production compared to demand. So, which means India will always be having inflationary pressure. But then, it's okay as long as that inflation should be under control. Thoda bahut mehngai theek hai, bahut zyada nahi. That's what it is. And today, if we are talking about that bahut zyada mehngai, that's the main reason why the finance minister is talking about. How should we, see, what is the target? Our target is to increase production to 5 trillion, which means production should increase. Now look at the contradiction. Listen very carefully. This is very logical here. Right now, India is experiencing high inflation. So what happens when inflation is there? Can production increase?
No.
Right? When inflation is there, mehngai is zyada hai. What happens when mehngai is zyada hai to? Obviously, when prices are high, people start consuming. So how can you increase demand? So what is the target of the finance minister? The finance minister is saying, let us give people the purchasing capacity. Let us increase their consumption. Let us drive demand. Now the target for the government is to drive demand. Therefore, what are they doing? They are giving certain benefits so that people will demand more, because if demand is high, what will happen to production? Production will increase. If production will increase, what will happen? Economic growth will take place. So how do you do that? Give people more money. So how do you give people more money? Chapo or sabko baato. Is that possible?
No.
Why? Listen very carefully now. Why? What will happen? What will happen if we have excess money supply in the country? Let's say finance minister has announced, sabko jo hai, paise batwa jayenge. What will happen then? Everybody will have money. What is money? We said money is only a medium of exchange for goods and services. आपके पास बहुत सारा पैसा है and that पैसे का equivalent goods and services नहीं है. What will happen to that value of money? It will fall. है कि नहीं? Value of money has value only when it is going to fetch you that equivalent amount of goods and services. So, a country can print currency, no doubt about it, but it will not have any value. So, therefore, when we talk about money circulation, point number one is excess, listen very carefully, excess money supply will cause inflation. इसीलिए मनी सप्लाई को जो है कितना मनी सप्लाई करना है कितना मनी को सर्कुलेट करना है दैट डिसीजन इज टेकन बाय हु बाय आरबीआई सो आरबीआई इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर दिस मनी सर्कुलेशन हाउ डज आरबीआई डू दिस मनी सर्कुलेशन इट डज दिस वाया बैंक्स दैट्स व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू सी इन बैंकिंग एम आई क्लियर इट डज इट वाया बैंक्स सो एक्सेस मनी सप्लाई विल कॉज इन्फ्लेशन देयरफॉर We need to control inflation. How do you control inflation? Control money supply. And how do you control money supply? RBI controls its money supply through its banks, through interest rates. Kyunki money jab borrow hota hai, we said that is the whole point of banking, right? People who don't have, who have, they're exchanging money with each other. Aur jab ye paisa jab rotate ho raha hai, it is not free. It is through interest. So that is the reason interest rates are going on fluctuating. Why? Because that is a way to control money supply. Remember I gave you all that example. Let's say you all are banks and I am RBI. Okay, I am giving money to you and you in turn are giving money into the market. Okay, now I know, say I am the control. I know that excess money supply will cause inflation. India is already under inflationary pressure. Toh woh rahega hi. It's okay. But I'm seeing, but I'm seeing whether it is under control or not. Let's say I see mahangai theek thaak hai. It's not very high. And I want money circulation to take place because money circulation is important for what?
Production.
So I as RBI, I look at inflation ki theek thaak hai ya nahi and then I decide. If inflation is okay, I decide to give you guys money. Now, when I decide to give you all money, now you would want to borrow at a higher rate or a lower rate? Nobody wants to buy at a higher rate. Why? Because if you borrow at a higher rate, you have to give outside at a higher rate. And nobody wants to borrow at a higher rate. So, because inflation is under control, listen very carefully. Because inflation is under control, I give you guys money at a lower interest rate. And you in turn give into the market at a lower interest rate. Am I clear? That's why interest rates. Let's say for example, inflation is high. Now when inflation is high, if I'm going to give you at a lower interest rate, it doesn't work. Inflation is already high. Why? Because what will happen? Excess money will cause further inflation. So I want to tighten. I want to tighten that money supply to you guys. So what should I do? Increase the interest rate. Are you understanding? Newcomers, are you all understanding? So, we did that table last time, right? So, we talked about inflation. Inflation levels. Two conditions. One, we are talking about inflation is under control. It's stable and second condition is when inflation is high. Let us see what is the money supply and what is interest rate connection to this. Okay. Now, let's first talk about money supply. Inflation is under control. When inflation is under control, what does RBI decide to do? Increase the money supply. It will increase money supply. Why? Because we require. Inflation control mein hai, theek thaak hai, we'll increase money supply. Now, I want to increase money supply. So, what will I do to the interest rate? I will decrease it. Is this logic clear to everybody? Madam, are you there? Are you understanding? All the newcomers today, do you get this logic? Because your whole understanding will be based on these things. go ahead.
It is said that 2-3% of inflation is still good for economy, is it right?
Yeah, that's what we discussed last class, no?
But I'm again not getting
the. That's the next level. Hold on. First, let's do this. We did that already. I told you all that little bit of inflation is good, right? That's what you're saying.
Yes.
We want to discuss that first. Is this clear?
Yes.
RBI circulates money to banks and banks in turn circulate money into the market. और ये जब हो रहा है, it is through interest rates. Am I clear? This is what is happening. RBI is circulating to banks and banks in turn is circulating into the market. Now, how much it has to give? That decision it has to take, no? RBI. Kitna circulation karna hai, kitna nahi karna hai, kaise control karna hai. How is that decision taken? It is based on inflation. Okay? Who measures this inflation? Who measures inflation? National Statistical Organization. They measure inflation. Who controls inflation?
RBI.
Okay? Who measures? Who controls? Measurement? Koi aur karta hai. That is every month ka mehengai kya ho raha hai, kaise ho raha hai, they will do it. And based on that, once in every 2 months, RBI will decide whether it wants to increase its interest rates or decrease interest, which just happened yesterday. Yesterday or day before yesterday? Right? Monetary policy. What did they do to the monetary policy? Rates are. And what did we say that it will happen? It will be because inflation is not really right high. Understanding now the monetary policy, how it worked and all that? Right. So this is how money circulation is taking place. And that's exactly why we need banks. For money circulation is what we said. Now let's come back here. Now we are not talking between banks. What we are going to see in banking is between banks and market. What we are seeing here is between RBI and banks. Clear? Now, inflation is under control. RBI decides to increase money supply. RBI paisa dena chahta hai banks ko. So what will happen to interest rate? It will decrease. Inflation is high. And we know, more if you give money, excess money will cause what? Further inflation. So RBI decides to reduce money supply. I don't want to give you guys money. What will I do? I'll increase the interest rate. If I increase interest rate to you, will you not increase the interest rate for the market? Of course, yes. Yahan pe thodi charity thodi chal raha hai ki, you know, you will get at a high rate and you will, that's not a business model. That's a loss making model. So when inflation level is high, interest rates also will increase. Am I clear? Okay. Now the decision of this increase and decrease in interest rates is taken once in every 2 months. And that is what we call it as what? Monetary
policy.
Which is a bi-monthly policy. What is the objective of the monetary policy? It is to control inflation. That's the whole point of monetary policy. Who gives the monetary policy? RBI. No Ministry of Finance here. Ministry of Finance ka role hota hai sirf income and expenditure, budget, ye sab ke liye. Baki sab jo money circulation ke liye hota hai, that is all the responsibility of RBI. So bi-monthly policy, that is a monetary policy. That is related to these interest rates, which just happened day before yesterday. Am I clear? So inflation, you know, is under control. Okay. So what will RBI do? You know, if our inflation is, let's say, under, it's high, either RBI wants to decrease money supply, let's say, but they will either increase the interest rates or they'll keep it unchanged, but definitely they will not decrease. So because right now India is under inflation, RBI decided what? let us keep it constant. What was there in the last monetary policy, we'll keep it remain, let the interest rates remain like that. Let's say for example, inflation agar, you know, control mein hota aur achhe se, you know, it'll fall down. Then what would have happened to the interest rates? Decrease.
Why didn't they increase the interest rate?
Why will they?
Why didn't they increase the interest rate?
If they increase further, what will happen to production then? See, now we are in a situation such that we need to drive production, we need to drive demand, we need to drive consumption. But already now the interest rates are low compared to the decade, the lowest interest rates we have. So that is exactly the next thing what I'm going to say. The decision why we are not reducing the interest rates is that is not going to boost economic growth. What is going to boost economic growth will be to increase consumption. It is not, because money circulation interest rates already come here. That is not going to help right now. So how do you increase consumption level, give people more money? How do you do that? That's the reason why we have tax cut. Remember, I talked about that. I told you all that the finance minister, already there was a talk and we saw that. So income tax you have reduced. So what happens when you reduce income tax? People are going to have more disposable income with them. If they have more disposable income, what will happen? Consumption will start increasing. That's one way to boost it. And we are also giving what? Tax benefit even to corporates. Tax benefit to supplier, tax benefit also to? For producer. For producer as well as to the consumer. So that you want to drive demand, drive consumption. Clear? Got it? Now, to answer your question, a little bit of inflation is good for the economy. Why? See, think about it. When we say inflation, can we have zero inflation as the target? No. What does that mean? Mathematically, if you look at zero inflation, you're talking about demand is equal to supply. Is that practically possible? No. Either you will have demand is more imbalanced to rahega. Kahan pe rehna chahiye is what you're looking at. Now, it will be very nice if we say that our supply is more than demand. But we don't have it. India, we are still growing as an economy. We are not a China wherein they have excess production. No. We are an India wherein our production is less. So which means, hame inflation rahega. But that inflation should be under control, and we said that limit for that control has been decided that it will be what? Inflation targeting framework is about 4% plus or minus 2% of GDP. This is what we said, and it remains to be that still now. So we said, theek hai, matlab, we are talking about between 2 to 6%. So we are saying, inflation to rahega hi, it's okay. अगर इन्फ्लेशन का रेंज इस रेंज में है, 2 to 6% के रेंज में है, तो ठीक है, वी कैन मैनेज. अगर इससे ज्यादा अगर हो गया, देन इट मींस दैट वी कांट मैनेज. एंड दिस 4% इज व्हाट वी आर ऑलवेज लुकिंग एट. अलार्म बेल इज एट 4%. इट्स लाइक 4% स्नूज करो 6 बजे तक, यू नो, इट्स लाइक दैट. सो यूर टॉकिंग अप लाइक टिल 6%. सो दैट 4% इज दैट अलार्म. It's okay, you're giving that margin, that window till 6%. But we are looking at it till 4% is what, you know, always we are looking at. Ab iska zimmedari kiska hai, ye inflation ko control karne ke liye hai? RBI. How does it do that? How is it that RBI is responsibility? It is through money circulation. So money circulation ka bari jab aata hai, kaise inflation ko control karna hai, that is RBI's responsibility. But jab consumption ko drive karna hai, jab, you know, demand or income, all these things, responsibility of Ministry of Finance. Am I clear? Right? So therefore, today we are saying, let us not talk about interest rates, just not talk about money circulation. Interest rates ko aur kam karke koi fayda nahi hoga. It is not going to help. What we have to push right now for Indian economy is, for growth of Indian economy, is to drive demand, drive consumption. That's what the budget was all about. How you could help creating that, creating that facility for people to start driving more डिमांड देयर. सो कहाँ थोड़ा बहुत टैक्सेस कम करना, यू नो, एंड विच वन दैट इज ऑलवेज देयर. सी दैट यूनिवर्स यू आर टॉकिंग, द टारगेट विच यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट बेसिक इनकम फॉर ड्राइविंग कंजम्पशन, या इट विल इंक्रीज, बट यू नो दैट इज मोर लाइक अ बर्डन फॉर द गवर्नमेंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ इट इज लाइक गिविंग सब्सिडीज.
But so is tax reform.
That's what we saw. Everything will be interrelated, right? We'll be seeing that interrelation, right? See, in fact, I mean, just think about this. Imagine if we just don't, what is the percentage of taxpayers in the country? Right? Chalo, 10% you keep. 10% of the population is only paying tax, right? So, don't you think, if you look at an economy, it should be like, remove all direct taxes. Don't tax people on income. Instead of that, tax everything on indirect taxes. That would be a really nice way of looking at things. Don't you think so? Right? But, don't you think so? Right? So, imagine, no income tax. That's how all these developed, a lot of countries operate, right? You don't tax them on, you know, no direct tax. Only indirect tax. Where is the question of tax evasion? Where is the question of, you know, black money and all these things? They don't come into picture.
Then prices will increase.
We are not in that situation. I mean, it's not like a mathematical thing that this happens and so therefore you get the result. It doesn't work like that. Right? So, I'm just saying, I mean, it would look like a very appealing model, but are we really ready as a country to do that? I don't know. I don't have that much of expertise to say that, are we ready as a country? But think about it. There are a lot of countries we see, no? A lot of countries, there are no taxes. So when I say there are no taxes, we are not talking about indirect taxes. We are talking about direct taxes. Yes.
But will indirect tax compensate with the revenue generation or direct tax?
That can happen only when you drive consumption. See, in developed economies, what happens is everybody's purchasing power is very high. So, sab log jo hai consume kar rahe. So, when consumption is higher, what happens? Tax collection of indirect tax. And think about the population. Like if you take a country like Australia, their population is much as only city of Mumbai, the whole country. Population of Mumbai is equal to population of country Australia. So, can we really afford to do that? I really don't know. Right? So, population is one. See, what is tax? I told you all last time. Tax is nothing but tax. What is the idea of taxes? Idea of taxes is
redistribution
of wealth. What do you mean by redistribution of wealth?
Taking from the rich,
distribute it to people so that inequality of the rich and poor reduces. And you can have a socio-economic justice. That's the whole objective. That's exactly what we talk about, the directive principles of the state policy. We're talking about socio-economic justice. That's the whole idea of taxation. Right? So there are a lot of countries which don't tax. The meaning is why they don't tax is because they have excess in money. India, do you think we'll reach that stage where the government says we have excess paisa, therefore we won't tax? That can never happen because we are a country where our population is very, very high. So, I don't think at least we'll be alive to see that. Maybe at some point in time. Right? So, therefore, okay. So, this is how this whole connection between economic growth and inflation that takes place. Now, to answer your question about that, why is it that we say that a little bit inflation is good for India? Now, as I said, inflation zero cannot be the target, okay? When there is a little bit of inflation, let's say for example, you all are producers, okay? If you're producers, there is always competition between producers to give their product at the best price possible. Hai na? Sabse sasta, sabse acha. That's what is our target all the time, to attract the market. Now, what are you doing to make your... I took that example of what? Mobile phones are something and I told you all, no? Every time you look at mobile phones, they're becoming better and better and they want to give it to you as the least price possible. Hai ki nahi? Why is it so? Because you know that the consumer is going to consume at the least price possible. So what are you doing? When the prices are going up, producers are always fighting among each other to reduce the price in the market so that the demand is high. Little bit of inflation meaning jab thoda bahut mehngai hota hai, right? It is good for the country because there is competition created in the market to reduce the price. And how is this? So in that process of reducing the price, production zyada ho jata hai. How can prices reduce? Prices can reduce only if production is high. If you produce only 100 mobiles in a year, your price will go to crores. But if you are going to produce lakhs of mobiles in a year, you can bring down the price. Simple cost of production, right? That's what it is. Did you get that logic now? So, a little bit of inflation, because we are a developing country, a little bit of inflation is good. Because it is going to drive more. Anyways, we are going to have inflation. Why we have inflation? Because our supply is less. Yeah, we are increasing. It is not that this is more. Supply is not becoming greater than demand, mind you. Supply is there. We are boosting that supply. So that we can always keep reducing the price. Think about it, mobile phones for example. Each company, one company comes suddenly takes over the other by slashing their prices in such a market that market is compelled that next phone jo inka hoga, us price se kam to de hi nahi payenge. That's the whole. That is the reason you have R&D, you have all these things that are taking place.
And then there's Apple.
Clear?
And then there's Apple.
those are exceptions, no? We saw last time. Exceptions of demand also we saw, no? Jiffin goods and Veblen goods we saw. See, exceptions are always there. Exceptions are what? Inferior goods and superior goods. Superior goods, for example, luxury goods. People buy luxury goods because it is having that luxury value. Right? Nobody is interested. See, people buy, let's say for example, a luxury car. Why do people buy luxury car? Car can be a normal car also. The purpose is not that. It's a luxury car. They are willing to give that extra money because of that exclusivity that it has. Those are exceptions. They don't follow this. What is the law of demand states? Law of demand states that when prices are low, demand will be high. The whole market works on this principle only. Everybody all the time are looking at how they can reduce the prices. But exceptions are there. For example, superior goods or luxury goods. That's an exception. Again, inferior goods also. Okay, inferior goods, for example, any inferior good you take. Let's say, for example, bread hoga, ya, you know, bajra, ya, you talk about salt or you talk about these kinds of things. Let's say. Inka prices ka increase or decrease aapke consumption ka decision change nahi hoga. Okay, they don't affect your consumption patterns. So the whole market is always talking about how much people are consuming. That becomes a little more of microeconomic concept. But then, this is how it is. Have you all understood inflation? So what is inflation? Types of inflation we saw. So the inflation that we look at, or RBI's decision for changing these interest rates through its monetary policy, that decision is based on what inflation? This one we talk about consumer price index, CPI. What is consumer price index? Jaise maine kaha, when we talk about production, production ke baad manufacturing stage se wholesale se retail, retail se consumer ke paas jata hai. When we talk about prices, har stage ka price alag alag hota hai. Manufacturing ke baad jo price hai jo manufacturer wholesaler ko bechta hai, wo price alag hai. Wholesaler जो retailer को बेचता है वो price अलग है और जो हम खरीदते हैं वो अलग है. अब you can calculate inflation या increase in prices, महंगाई कहाँ पे हो रहा है, कहीं पे भी आप calculate, कहीं पे भी measure कर सकते हो, not calculate, measure कर सकते हो. For example, I can look, go to the wholesale market and see what is the increase in prices in the wholesale market. I can compare it at retail market. So the decision what RBI takes is not on wholesale price, it takes on retail price, consumer price. So when we say, you know, inflation is, for example, we had recent news about inflation to kitna hai and all that. So if inflation was, let's say 4.8%, 5% is what RBI has measured, I mean, NSO has measured and RBI has seen that much as the inflation. What inflation I'm talking about? CPI inflation. Got it? Consumer price index. So the decision of the change of interest rates, the decision of the monetary policy, the decision of functioning of this money supply from our, all that is based on what inflation? CPI inflation. Clear? I think we finished till here in the last class. Okay. Of course, we did so many details on that. So for people who've come only today, please look at the notes and all that.